Hi, my name is Hardy Rupan, and I am the Man in the Wild. And in today's episode, I'm going to show you how to build and cook with a clean burning stove using just a tuna can. If you would like to support the channel, please subscribe, like, comment, and most of all, share this video. Stay tuned. If you would like to support my channel, you can join me on my adventures by liking and subscribing to this channel. Today, I will be taking you to one of my many campsites that I usually go to cook a meal and enjoy the ambience. Join me. It has been raining for the past couple of days, and the ground is quite wet. But today is a beautiful sunny day, and I am going to enjoy a day in the outdoors. I will start by getting some leaves to cover the wet ground. Locally, these leaves are called Suhari leaves or Kasimbo leaves. I now need to get a thin green stock to start constructing my stove. I will now cut three pieces, approximately 6 inches or 15 centimeters long. These three pieces will be sharpened into stakes. If you would like to support my channel, you can join me on my adventures by liking and subscribing to this channel. After setting up my kitchen, it is now time to construct my stove. A simple, empty tuna can is used for this. Together with the three steaks we prepared earlier. The steaks will be used as the pot stand, and the tuna can is going to be the stove. I will place the steaks into the ground in a triangular formation, no larger than the base of the pot I'm going to be using. The steaks are placed into the ground with a distance of 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters above the tuna can. Ensure that the pot fits and the pot stand is level. This is the arrangement of the stove. Now that the stove is ready, we are going to prepare some ingredients to cook our meal. Dice 1/2 of an onion. Two green pimento peppers, dice 2 grain of garlic, one half of a yellow hot pepper. Thinly slice one ripe tomato. finely chop one leaf of parsley. All of these finely chopped ingredients, together with some minced corn meat, we will be preparing our meal. It's now time to get our stove started. To get the stove going, we will be using an alcohol fuel. I am using mentholated spirit. You can use any alcohol you have, like rubbing alcohol, or even icy purple alcohol. Fill the tuna can up to about 3/4. That will give you about 45 minutes of flame. Ignite the fuel and the stove is ready to go. If you do not need to use the stove for that long, you can always fill it with less fuel. The chopped ingredients is first added. If you would like to support my channel, you can join me on my adventures by liking and subscribing to this channel. After the vegetables have softened a bit, you can add the minced corn meat. Some tomato ketchup is added for extra flavor. No salt is added to this recipe. My meal is almost ready, so I will prepare some delicious herbal tea. My herbal tea would be made from these leaves that I freshly picked on my hike in. This herb is locally called karakeet. It's found in the wild, high in vitamin C, and has a delicious minty flavor. My meal is now ready, so I will put on the kettle. This looks so delicious. While the tea is getting ready, I will prepare a delicious wrap. Topped off with some lettuce, mustard, and my favorite, developed right here in Trinidad, the world-famous Moringa, scorpion, pepper. Just a little will do. The tea is ready. There is still some fuel left in the stove. To turn off the stove, you simply cover it with a larger utensil. This stifles out the oxygen and the flame goes out. You can now empty the fuel back into its original container. It's now time to enjoy some hot herbal tea with my delicious wrap. This is so delicious. It's wonderful to be out in the wilderness and enjoy a freshly cooked meal. It was so good, I had to have a second wrap and a second cup of tea. It is so wonderful to be able to enjoy nature in such a magnificent way. I always enjoy coming into the forest, cooking a meal, and just relaxing and taking in all that nature has to offer. If you would like to support my channel, you can join me on my adventures by liking and subscribing to this channel. If you would like to support my channel, you can join me on my adventures by liking and subscribing to this channel. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to support my channel.